We appreciate the head of the ministry of Father in the North. That's on earth. We have general head, which is our God. But on earth, that God has given a mantle of this commission to our Father in the North. A man that does not talk, but is pulling, destroying the kingdom of darkness in this generation. And we are privileged to be under him. And never you look back because God is taking us somewhere. And also appreciate the men who God is using in this branch, the women who God is using, the youth, and generally. Please, let's have a big God, have an assignment for God. If we fail in our time, we are failed to time. Every generation, God is asking people to put things on you. Yesterday, I was so tired and so many other things in my hand. I said, why stress like this? And God said to me, I was in the church here, and he said, you're collecting some of these people, because some of these people we are looking at, they have sold their heart to Satan. Their heart is already in the hand of Satan, just like putting somebody inside of them. And they are just like what Jesus tried to do for Jesus. Sorry, Satan said, serve me, worship me, I'll give you the treasure of the world. And Jesus said, no. Some of these men, God said, some of these men, they are already, they are already taking their heart and give them the glory of God. That to collect what they sow with their heart, to collect what they sow with their heart, it may not be for you. You must pay the price. Because our heart is in God. And these people, their treasure, their wealth, their soul is in hell. They will have taken that soul. To collect it for your job to remain, for your peace to remain, you must pay the price. When I hear this, I encourage myself. And I come to announce to somebody, the word of God can never be broken. Every good thing that is desired is in the hand of somebody, in the hand of wrong person. God shall shift it to your hand in the name of Jesus. God will shift it to your hand in the name of Jesus. And if God wants to shift it, he will not shift them easy. You are like to pass through some challenges to prove whether cannot go or not to go. And the Bible says, when you fail in the day of trouble, your strength is restored. I encourage the men, the women, and everyone, let us continue. We are going somewhere. And by the time we arrive, even though the devil will know that we are not honoring, and so shall he be in the name of Jesus. And this Joshua, we are looking at the scripture very quickly. We are reading Psalm 91 all this one. Psalm 91, verse 1 to 2. Psalm 91 verse 1 and 2. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. And verse 2 quickly, we say of the Lord, he is refuge and my fortress, my God, in whom we trust, or whom I trust. Give us 10 and 11, the same scripture. The same Psalm 91 and 10, 11. There shall no evil befall thee. Neither shall any plague come near that dwelling. And verse 11. For he shall give his angel charge over thee to keep thee in the way. What are we looking at this morning? It's going to be very brief because so many things on ground for us to handle this one. Divine power for angels' assignment. Divine power for angels' assignment. I think for a very long time we have not preached a message that the Holy Spirit has not directed us to a message. I want to listen very well. God wants to open our eyes that we are not alone. God wants to open our eyes that every believer is not a joker. Every believer, if you have a little quality of Jesus in you, you are not a joker. In brackets and cloak, I call the ministry of angels by divine power of God. We are sharing divine power for angel assignment. Can brackets and close are writing the ministry of angel by divine power of God. Our focus is understanding the preservation power of the ministry of angels of God. We are hearing them, many of our angels, but don't know what it is, or what it is, or how they look like, or their function. By way of introduction, I'll take note of this. Angels are real. by way of introduction. Angels are we. If you don't understand that for the way human beings be, the way demons are we, angels are we. Don't forget that one you all. And number two, take note of this. The major agenda of angel is for preservation of the saints. The major agenda, their function, is to preserve the saints. I'm not talking about our saints, I'm talking about the saints. Everybody here is saints. Somebody say amen. The major assignment of angel is to preserve the saints. Those appear the mark of Jesus Christ. Therefore, if you are not part of heaven, you are waving, your leg is so low and your leg and leg is Sabara, you may be missing the Lord. Because demons will be dragging you and the angel will not be helping you. Those that are connected to heaven, that the major assignment of angels alone are for preservation. And final place is Psalm 35 and verse 6. Peter, if you can be helping on Psalm 35 and verse 6, we'll be taking some scripture to back up our reality. So Psalm 35 and verse 6. Let their way be dark and slippery. Those that are against you, they are the enemies to angels of God. Those that have tried to write you down, the angel become their enemy.